So guys, here at Eurovoxx, we don't feel hate, but we don't feel sorry either, because we're back to Voxx Verdict 2021. We're talking about Jendrik and his song for Germany. We're going to review it and let you guys know what we think.
I don't feel hate, I just feel sorry. So you can wiggle at the made a thing that it'll never wiggle back to you. Cause I don't feel...
So, Clara, let's come to you first. What are you thinking of Germany's chances this year?
I am super surprised that Germany would send a song like this. It's amazing. I like it so much. It's so much fun. It's so colorful. It's so bang in your face, everything. And the music is really nice. The song itself is really nice. And the visuals that come with the song are very catchy. So I was instantly won. And I did not expect something from Germany like this, because you know Germany has like a track of sending songs that you can very easily tell that they are going to end on the lower level, on the lower part of the scoreboard. But this one, I just don't feel that hate.
Do you feel sorry?
Sorry, but I don't even feel sorry. And this song is a doorway to so many fans. And I love it. And I like Jendrik's energy so much. I like his charisma. I like that he can sing so fast that nobody's going to be able to replicate that. And not me, definitely. And I like the melody. I like the ukulele. I like the track. I really like this song. Yes, indeed.
Come on, Stu. Surely you can't have been expecting a song like this for Germany.
I wasn't expecting a song like this for Germany, and I have to applaud them for taking a risk, because this, you know, it's not like any of the other entries that we see this year or one of the entries that we see from Germany. And as Clara kind of alluded to, we do tend to see Germany play it safe, and that has not worked in their favor on a number of occasions. As far as how I feel about the song personally, really not my thing, I have to say. It's like... musically, it just sounds like something lifted from anyone's YouTube vlog. And I could almost like put it on in the background and hear people going like, "Hey guys, sorry I haven't made a video in a long time. Let me tell you about my life," you know? So it's just, yeah, it's not my thing. I'm not saying, I don't feel hate. I do feel a little bit sorry though, because you know, I appreciate its uniqueness. I think that this certainly could have an audience. But what I worry about is the fact that it has to walk a fine line between being humorous and being chaotic and kind of messy, because there are other acts this year that are bringing something that's fun and wholesome, like Iceland, like Denmark. Obviously, we don't know if Denmark will be in the final, but if they do, that'll definitely be a threat to them. And then if Germany comes in doing this thing that just feels totally unhinged, then, and especially, you know, when you consider the fact that there are other songs here that are reaching people on emotional levels, I do see a potential here to also do poorly. So, I mean, it's not to say that they shouldn't be taking risks, because obviously a risk is better than what they've been doing in the past. But yeah, on a personal level, not really liking this, and I could see this as being potentially disastrous, but they could also get this, they could get this right. I think it just comes down to, you know, yeah, not making it chaotic.
See, I've gone like, done a total 360 on this song. I remember when I first watched it, it felt like something that I shouldn't like, but I really enjoyed watching it, and I enjoyed watching him perform it in his video. And then I'm thinking, are Germany just not trying? Are they not putting in an effort this year? Then I listen to it on my Spotify and it gets me dancing around. It makes me feel happy. This song makes me feel so many different ways. You know, I can't tell if it's a joke or whether it's just him being himself. And it's so hard to call how this is going to do. However, I think people will fall in love with him, and I think he is the key to this song's success rather than the song itself, because he's so happy. He's so kind of unaffected by all the hate. And let's remember, he's had a lot of hate just by becoming Germany's entrant. I mean, he's shown it on his Instagram feed, some of the comments that he's had from people, you know, quite some like homophobic slurs, and it's just disgusting. And that kind of makes me will him on even more. But this is going to be something that people are going to watch. They're going to love him. They're going to think it's 3 minutes of fun. It's 3 minutes of something that's not that serious. We're out of being in a, well, I say we're out, we're still in a pandemic, but it's been a year now since we were all kind of locking down all around Europe. And maybe this is what Europe will want 3 minutes of. I don't know. So I don't think it's going to be a last place for Germany. I think this one could be a surprise. Yes, maybe it's not going to get all the jury votes, but I think televoters potentially will really like this. And I think this is going to appeal to the casual Eurovision viewer rather than the kind of Eurovision fans. So really interesting to see how this will do. And we've got a couple of guys who also want to talk about this, Paolo and Chris.
I have to say, first of all, I was very curious when I heard that Jendrik is going to take part for Germany in this year's contest, because we actually didn't know him that well before. There was only one video on YouTube. So I was very excited to see what we are going to offer this year to the contest. And I have to say, I'm very surprised in a positive way, because it's a song which is not safe. And it's actually a little risk to send this, but I love the message. I love Jendrik. And I think that he can definitely give us a great show in Rotterdam in May. And I wish best of luck to my country. And I'm in love. So 12 points to Germany.
I absolutely love this. It's a feel-good song. It brings a massive smile to my face. And it brings so much joy. And it makes me happy. And I'm sure it will make a lot of people happy that will be watching the contest. And I think that with the year that we have just had, we need something that does that in this contest. It'll like something to just bring a massive smile to our face, bring the energy, bring the fun, and I think this song can absolutely do it. And I think Jendrik is a character in his own right. I think his personality absolutely shines through this song. He's so adorable. And I love the message that this song brings as well. Don't feel hate and that sort of stuff. Yeah, I hope this does well, because I think we need this type of song in the contest, and I love these types of songs anyways. And I love the addition of the tap break as well. I love it. I absolutely love it.
So there we go, guys. As always, we're going to assign our emojis to Germany's song. Clara, let's come to you, as if I need to ask.
Ta-da! I really like this song. It does it for me. I put it on my headphones while I walk around the city, and it gets my day going by. And I don't know, this is a functional song for me. It makes me happy. It lifts my mood. It lifts my spirit, and it makes me power walk. So, yay.
Well, this is mine. I feel like I really shouldn't like it, but it just hooks me in every time. I can't wait just to see him performing this and see his dream coming true, because this has all been about his journey to Eurovision. He's spoken openly about kind of how he started with an idea and now he can't believe where he is. And that really excites me. Like I said, it's going to be 3 minutes of fun on the Eurovision stage. It's harmless. So, yeah, I like it. And for that, I'm not sorry. You.
Okay, so I'm going to be on the lower end of things again. This is a dislike for me, not feeling it, not my type of song. I will say, though, that if they are able to execute it in the right way where it is fun and, you know, makes me laugh, then I could also do that same kind of 180 that you did, Andy, on this song. But we'll have to see.
Well, there we go, guys. But as always, guys, it's not just us voting. We've got to take a look at the scores of the Voxx squad. So here it is. Pretty across the board, we've got 11 people liking it, so that looks like the main decision of the Voxx squad. A few people not liking it. I imagine you're in that list, Stu. But hey, there we go. But guys, as always, we would love to know what you think of Germany's entry, Jendrik, with I Don't Feel Hate. So drop a comment down below and let us know. Otherwise, go to our Facebook page, give us a like, and hit us on find us on Instagram. Until the next one, guys. See ya. We'll be right back.